A lot of people that would have not had to lose significant portions of their paychecks.
The city's photo enforcement stats are in, and a change to the length of yellow lights on 80 kilometer per hour roads has already seen tickets plummet.
It's basically down to physics that faster cars need more time to stop. That it's basically that simple.
For years, yellow or amber lights across Winnipeg were 4 seconds in duration. Chris Suareta, a traffic safety advocate, made a case that Winnipeg was one of the last places in Western Canada not increasing light duration by travel speed of road. City Councillor Matt Allard moved forward a report that found that light duration on 80 kilometer per hour roads should be 4.7 seconds.
Public Service did agree that we should lengthen the time of those amber lights. And since then, preliminary data seems to indicate from the police reporting that tickets are down. So it looks like there has been an impact.
City data shows a drop in red light offenses at the two cameras located on 80 kilometer roads by 85% between the fourth quarter of 2019 and the same time in 2020. The changes were made in August of last year. Westbound Bishop Grandin at River Road saw a reduction in tickets from 357 to 50, and southbound Lajimodiere Boulevard at Grassy Boulevard saw a reduction from 280 to 44.
You can clearly see the problem when they are producing numbers like 12 and 1300 and in that range red light tickets annually, while other intersections are down in like the range of like 1 or 200.
Allard says the numbers are favorable, but doesn't discount lower driver numbers on the roads due to COVID-19. Suareta points to speeding tickets staying nearly the same year over year as evidence there were still similar driver numbers. Suareta takes issue with the city making this move so late. He says the city should have at least made these changes before traffic cameras were installed in 2003 to save Winnipeggers some money on tickets he believes they didn't deserve. A written response from the city reads in part, "When the Public Service reviewed amber lights in 2020 with the help of improvements in signal timing technology, including a combination of the technical research from national and international organizations and engineering judgment applied appropriately with knowledge of local context to calculate the amber light duration values, we were able to implement more precisely calculated amber light timings and follow best practices." In Winnipeg, Mike Albanese, City News.